Hello, and welcome to Tales of Berseria. As you all can tell, I hope you all had a great 4th of July, or Independence Day, if you're in the States. We are back from vacation. And over the vacation, I thought and thought and thought and thought, and I kept coming back to Tales of Berseria. I promise you, I'm not just going to play Tales games. But I just kept coming back to it. It's the next one I want to play. I have to say, this is probably my favorite Tales game I have played. As the second best opening. Tales of Symphonia was fun. It's a fun game. Dawn of a New World. Combat was really had me. Not all that keen on it. They really, if they, I doubt they're gonna do another remake, but excuse me, I still have a cough, by the way. If they do another remake or ever re-release the game again, I hope they take a look at the combat system, because it really was annoying. But Tales of Berseria, like I said, is probably my favorite Tales game out there as of right now. Second best opening. First, I have to give to the English Tales of Zestiria. So the sequel to this game, which is actually, this game's a prequel because it came out after Zestiria. Zestiria, but they're in the same world. It's something like a 500,000 year time difference. Yeah, Zestiria's opening is the best, and I'm trying to learn it. Anyways, so we're gonna jump in this. As you can see, I have beaten this game in the past. It has been a few years since I played it. I remember bits and pieces of it. Probably better than Tales of Symphonia, but it has been a few years. So, we shall see how this goes. And we'll do this until I get my hands on the new game that I ordered. It comes up. When it comes in, we'll probably play between the two of them. Also, I talked to Sam about Pokemon. His schedule's still up in there, so maybe we can get some more Pokemon in this week or this upcoming weekend. So let's go ahead and dive into Tales of Berseria. I think this time we're going to go with the New Game Plus, since I do have my save data. As you can see, the last time I played was on May 6th, 2017. 4 p.m. 2017. Must have took that day off from work. That was 3 years ago. I don't think it was a week. Six film weekend. I made it. May have. It's about a 60-hour game. Well, I did a bunch of additional side stuff, so around 50-60-hour game. And I made it to level 121. I'm sure if I hop in there, I can get that up some more. But we're gonna do the game plus. Yes. And let's see what options we get to play with. New Game Plus is typically harder. The add-on you have purchased qualifies you to carry over the following without using any grade. Expanded. Apparently I bought add-ons. Expanded item. I bet that's important. Double our learning speed, double experience, double gold, half price enchanting, double grade. Allows you to carry over the following without using any grade. Max HP 1000, 1 and 2, so 2000. Carry over equipment proficiency. Only available if carry over titles have been selected. Huh. Okay, how much? I have 3,500. Library, shop levels, count, glaciate. Add skills to. So I. Again, I don't know. Explorations. Rational items are not included. And will have to be found again. Inherit. Additions. Carry over cooking. Cat spirits. Hell's coins, special items, bottomless. Until the team locked. Carry over my consumables. Carry over fashion items. Head size attachment, geo boards, urban enhancements. Okay, got that. Always wondered there was a chance of encountering enemies. Level up bonus. Add level up bonuses to all titles. Stats, maybe, but I go below zero. Half experience. Character changer. Generates 50% of BG gauge for switching class. Essentially having us for using half the experience, triple the experience for 3,000. Nah. Enhanced drops dropped by enemy. Ooh. That all that
Okay. I think we want to do that. Grab that. I want to grab that. Might as well. Ooh! Stat boots, granted. Herbs. So 37. I only have 35. So I need to drop 200. And level up bonuses to all titles and sets increase, maybe they will not go below zero. I don't know if... I don't know if enchant it drops it. Is good idea. I mean, that sounds good. I'm a little iffy on that one. Zap boost granted from herbs. Choices. I'm not that far off from not being able to have all of it. It's enhanced. A good idea would be better to do that. Frequently dropped by enemies have chance of being enhanced. What's... Oh, fuck it, we'll just go like this. I don't know if that's good or bad.
You hide here, Velvet. I'm going back to help Celica.
I'm so scared. Arthur, please.
You'll be just fine with these. Celica enchanted them herself. They'll give you the courage you need to survive.
They will?
Sure they will. Now, have I ever lied to you? I'll come back for you once Celica is safe. It's scary, but don't give in to fear. Don't despair, no matter what.
I won't. I promise. After all, I'm Laffy's older sister, and your student.
On that day, the world began to change. Men and beasts possessed by evil spirits, hunting and killing anyone they could. But even in the depths of despair, only two things matter to me. The taste of blood-soaked flesh. And revenge upon one man.
Laffy, time to wake up.
Okay.
Morning.
I told you to stop calling me Laffy. I'm not a little kid anymore.
Grumble, grumble, huh? You must be feeling good. Bit of a fever, I'm afraid. At least the new medicine's supposed to come today. Until then, you stay in bed, got it?
What? Aw, but I wanted to go to the Cape.
Sorry, you'll have to wait.
Can I at least read a book?
Don't trouble your sister, Lafayette.
I didn't mean to.
Arthur, done chopping firewood?
Yeah, enough to last through winter. But there's something else I need to take care of. Sorry, but medicine money'll have to wait a bit.
I can earn it myself, then. Bring down a few prickle boars, and I'll have plenty to offer in trade.
On your own?
Arthur's first maxim. Plans must be solid and reactions flexible.
All right. I shouldn't doubt my student's abilities. Sorry to put you in a spot.
I'm sorry, Velvet.
Whoa, hey! What's everyone apologizing for? We're a family, right?
Right. I'll see you later.
I whipped up some porridge for you, okay? Be back by evening.
Thank you. Be careful, Velvet.
Okay, kind of, I've got, lack of a better term, intense opening. Menu? I should have read that. actually doesn't do anything, objective. Start skill cancel. But I can't wait to pause game. Ah, that's the center button. And I have to say, I can tell something's off with her costume. by the fact, that is not Velvet's usual, Oh. Master skill attack plus 5. To not lose sword. Sword down. Okay. Do we set to revive if we need? Okay, so that one looks good. Non-elemental damage. It's about 5%. So yeah, I think that's what I want. Nothing there. Battle boots, nothing. There we go. So, guess this was a lot of things that I unlocked. So, yeah, I guess maybe later on we can play around with all this, but kinda just wanna yeah, we can go ahead and save this current setup. So let's actually so I assume I either unlocked all these or the DLCs. So let's make, he's in the village, so I guess we could play around with all these I have no idea what some of these are. Play around with these as we go. We change some things up. Battle music. What the crap is that? Isn't it? Yeah, this is just her regular outfit. So what the? Does it play some special music in battle or something? So we'll just put it back to default. Like I said, we may play around with this stuff later in the game. I have a feeling that the other characters are going to be like that. Strategy. Arts. I guess I got all my arts to follow me. What is this next page? Oh. Okay. Wrong one. There we go. Change your control mode to manual. I hope they go over our arts. And how to use them. A lot of things have changed. That. So this is all materials. I assume they go over all this stuff. Bunch of costumes for everyone, so we'll knock them all. So let's just kind of go through all that. So these are DLCs. So I take it at some point I was in a bind. I think. Who knows? So, why are you still saying that you know you're not new? Very system. Let's do that so we don't get pick up from the controller. I guess subtitles on just fine. Okay. Take a look around here. Looky, looky, look. Nothing. And she just jumped down.
Rest up, alright?
Don't forget to take some gels with you. You know, you're careless sometimes.
I'll be fine. You just make sure.
Don't worry about me. I'll be in bed resting.
You better be.
Who's Velvet's voice actor? Sounds familiar. Can't peg it though. Minimap, of course. Area map. Boxes, okay. Objective. One bug.
If I'm on the hunt for prickle boars, I'd better try the tranquil woods outside of town. This is for Luffy's medicine, so I can't mess this up. Come to think of it, Arthur hasn't requested his favorite dinner in a while. There's been so much going on, and the village always has him out hunting. Maybe he's just worn out? That does it! I'll cook him up some prickle boar stew, just like Celica taught me. That ought to pick him right up. A healthy portion of nourishing meat cures fevers and weariness alike.
And we have skits. Skits. A bit more animated.
Ever since the opening 7 years ago, this world's really gone crazy. Famine, freezing weather, and worst of all, this demon blight that's turning people into monsters.
I can't believe that people can really turn into those things. It's a nightmare.
Does no one know what causes demon blight? Or how to heal it?
No. What we do know is that when people turn into those monsters, I mean, demons, they gain incredible strength and attack humans on sight.
Whoever named it the opening named it right. It's like someone opened a portal directly to hell.
Come to think of it, Celica died during the opening, didn't she? It might be a good thing she died when she did. She didn't have to suffer through all of this.
It's good that my sister died? How can you say that?
Sorry. I didn't mean it that way.
You're a real idiot, you know that?
Sorry about him, Velvet.
Fashion. We don't have, one of these is status. Yeah, don't have that quite yet. My titles. that X2? Treasure chest X2.
Hey, Velvet. Is Lafayette feeling better?
No, not yet. He needs a little more rest, I think.
Aw, too bad. Tell him I'm looking forward to hunting beetles with him again when he's better.
Right, got it. Lafayette's illness sure is persistent. Yeah, that fever still keeps coming back, like clockwork. The medicine always helps a little bit, but still, that sounds terrible. Let me know if there's anything I can do to help. Thanks, but we'll be fine. At least we've got Arthur to take care of anything that needs muscle. And before he came, Celica raised me and Luffy all by herself. So now I have to do my best too. You sound just like your sister. That optimism must run in the family. I do? That's nice of you to say.
Why does it say that I need to still talk to Luffy? And still want to know what the hell that treasure chest X2 means. There's treasure chest somewhere? What's to grab? Ah, who bloody knows? Get a bunch of that. Okay, there's no treasure chests here, but it still says we need to talk to this guy.
Keep warm and no going outside.
Sheesh, you don't trust me at all. It'll get dark if you don't leave soon.
Okay. I have to talk to him a second time. So that's two treasure chests here then. Got it. I don't see any.
I should probably stock up on a few things before I go into the forest. I don't have a lot of money to spare, but like Arthur always says, battles are won and lost with the preparations made before the first strike.
Oh, okay. So that's one church chest. Pigs. That's a save point. Alright, Robert, doing a little shopping today. I just stock up before heading out. Hunter's only as good as her supplies after all. What are we doing, by the way? All very healthy, thank you. Do you want to try changing the little one's diaper? It won't be long before you're doing it for real, you know. I don't think I'm ready for that just yet. I'm only 16. But changing diapers I can do. Time passes quicker than you think, and you're a pretty girl. So the boys in the village will be picking up on that. Boys from out of town, too. Better go hunt while there's still light. Talk to you later. I didn't mean to scare you. Alright, dear. Take care. Now you're here. Wanted to talk to the doggy. That's not the chest. Bye. Don't have all that much money. Thank you. You know what? If I was smart, I would have loaded up that other my save file and yanked all my equipment off my characters. But I'm not smart. Well, I think of things afterwards. Okay, cool, I did not save over my completed game. I'm back here to talk to.
The Demon Blight is a punishment. Sent to us by the Empyreans for forgetting the old prayers.
Who are the Empyreans?
The four Empyreans created the world. The one Empyrean shall bring it to peace. Be afraid. When contradiction permeates this world, the time of suppression will be upon us.
Are you okay? Want me to take you home?
No! Don't treat me like a child!
All right, then.
Oh, it's you, Velvet. If you're going to the Cape, take care.
Don't fall into the Shrine of Tranquility, right? I know. I'm not a kid.
Of course, of course. You're 13 now, aren't you?
I'm 16.
Oh, poor Velvet. It seems like the villagers are picking on her. Tranquil Woods.
This area looks promising.
Guess the stars are where we need to go to. let's see what's back here. Back here? Nope, just a wall. Hey, what's that?
There! Prickle Boar!
Come on.
Here goes!
What's up with those 5 diamonds?
Yeah, that's how it's done.
That's a little curious.
The cold weather's been terrible on everyone's crops, but at least the city will buy our prickle boar meat now. Luffy and Arthur have been hoping the village could start raising them, but they can just be so temperamental. I wonder if they could be bred with more docile pigs. What would we call them? Oinkle boars? Nah, doesn't sound appetizing. What about pickle boar? Yeah, pickle boar! That's a cute name. Maybe too cute, though. We wouldn't want to discourage people from eating them.
Okay, Velvet. Let's go this way. Hey, there's a chest.
Right, here goes! Arthur, second medicine. Know your foes and strike where they're weak.
Oh, come on.
Is that all?
So, what's the combination? Can't go that way yet. I will check out that other way when we get back. Or head back. Well, let's make a little savey save. Just in case something catastrophic happens, and I'm pretty sure this is like every other Tales game. You die, it's game over. You gotta go back to your last save point.
Right, here goes!
Megasonic Vest.
This should be enough to cover the medicine. I'd better bring these to the store. This place isn't safe. That hole's gotten bigger. I've told them 1,000 times they ought to build a fence, but they keep saying it's forbidden land. Even Celica used to scare me with it. She was always, "This is a gateway to the underworld." Well, I'm too old to keep falling for that nonsense.
Damn it, I was just thinking about something that we were gonna check and I fucking forgot. What was it? Well, that's right. Ooh, dodge that. Arts. So that goes to Swallow Dance. That goes to Rising Moon. Gouge Spin to Harsh. To Rising Moon. To... Okay, I see now. Okay, you can go to Gouge Spin. Which goes to... shortcut or something.
Right, here goes!
Okay, yes it does. Okay, I'm remembering the combat, how it's supposed to happen.
Not bad. Wait, the boars I hunted, are you there? Maxim 3, never waver once your sword is drawn. Control your feelings to control the tide of battle.
Hey,
Ah, goddammit.
I did it!
Cirrus!
An exorcist art!
Pride and anxiety, pity for the enemy, thrill of victory. Your emotions run too hot. That will be your downfall. Agreed. It's one of her virtues as well.
Huh?
Yes, I know. But even so, she's got to...
Arthur?
Arthur's fourth maxim. Never let your guard down, even when victorious.
Got it.
In any case, this should be enough to buy Lafayette's medicine. I'll drop the prickle boars off at the shop before I head out.
Head out where?
The person I was supposed to meet is late. I don't think I'll be home tonight. I came out here to let you know. You'll have to pick up the medicine yourself.
Right.
One more thing. I saw a group of demons near the village. If you're attacked, run away. Am I clear?
No way! I can handle a bunch of-
Demons can only be challenged by those with the talent for exorcism. That's the cold logic of the world, and no emotions can change it.
Do you think I could become an exorcist?
Why is it you think that birds fly?
Why? Well, without flying, they couldn't find food.
It takes a particular innate talent to be an exorcist. Unfortunately, very few humans have it within themselves.
All right.
Tomorrow is Celica's Memorial Day. I'll be back as soon as I can.
Hurry back! I'll make you a quiche, just the way she taught me. I wonder if those prickle boars were brothers. Maybe I should have let them go. But then, how would I pay for Laffy's medicine? Hunting took care of that. And it means food for us as well. I had no other choice. It was a rational decision. But the fact that I'm still worrying about it shows that my feelings are getting the better of me.
That is my moment. Okay, we can't go up that way yet. I think we come back here later in the game. And I believe where we need to go is the store. Yep.
Here for groceries?
Yep. And you must have been out hunting.
Yeah, it was a good haul.
Look at you, Lady Breadwinner. If you were a boy, I think I'd be in love.
Good thing I'm a girl.
Oh, yeah? You ought to do something about your style, then.
Yeah. I kind of broke my comb.
So get a new one.
Sure, I'd like to, but...
Hey, mister! How about a sale on combs for the pretty girl?
Huh? Oh, you two need something?
I'm fine, Nico. I'm just here to pick up medicine for Lafayette.
Oh, Velvet. I already told Arthur, but I'm afraid the medicine hasn't come in yet.
What? Why not?
Is it because of the demons?
Seems like the demon blight's really taking a toll on the city. There's even a group of them lurking around here now.
When's it coming, then?
I can't say. And I don't know how much it will cost.
Oh, no.
Ugh, what is wrong with Midgand? I mean, don't they have an army or something?
Those guys? The demons already routed them a while back.
But we're safe here, right? After all, your brother-in-law's an exorcist.
You so sure about that? Arthur can't even use his right hand anymore. Poor fellow couldn't even protect his own wife and child.
Let me know when the medicine gets in.
Of course. For now, here, on the house.
Velvet! You didn't forget, did you?
You promised to teach me how to make your special quiche.
You mean for that apprentice animal doctor you had your eye on? You were serious?
Beyond serious!
Please, this is life or death for me. But I thought your folks weren't keen on the two of you dating.
Who cares what people think? The important thing is my feelings.
I like the way you talk. If I were a boy, I think I'd be in love.
Darn right.
Okay,
you must be starving by now. I better hurry home. Orthy and Russ seem pretty down today.
I know. They've been whimpering like this for an hour now.
Well, they've always been a bit wimpy. The other day, that kitty Rollo chased both of them up a tree by himself.
They're hopeless. Whenever it's thundering out, they both dive into my bed, shivering.
Orthy, Russ, shape up. You're Nico's bodyguards, right? Start acting like it. They're completely hopeless.
Maybe.
But they're so cute,
so I forgive them.
Yeah, I can't be mad at doggies.
Celica taught you how to make your special quiches, right, Velvet?
Yeah, but mine aren't nearly as good as hers.
Don't be modest! They're fantastic! Simple, yet elegant.
That's because there's a secret in the cheese and the dough.
You should try selling them in Taliesin. I'm sure they'd be a hit. We could make them together and take them on the road! We could even wear matching uniforms!
Would it make more money than hunting frickleboars?
Definitely, maybe. Even more so if you could lighten up a bit in front of the customers.
Then it might be worth a try. I do want to buy Laffy a nice heavy winter coat. And Arthur's gloves are in tatters, so he needs new ones.
Oh, don't be so boring! I get where you're coming from, but come on! Think big! Dream, Velvet! Dream!
Think big? No thanks. I want a peaceful life with Laffy and Arthur. That's all.
You're impossible. Then again, maybe that's why your quiches taste so darn good.
All right, let's go. Ah, goddamn.
Hi, Celica. I'm back. I can't believe it's been 7 years since we lost you. And the baby you carried. Oh, drat. I forgot to bring your princessias. I know how much you, Mom, and Dad all loved those flowers. And I know your child would have too. I'm sorry. I'll pick some from the cape tomorrow.
Welcome home, Velvet.
Laffy, I told you to stay in bed.
I was only up for a little.
Look, your fever hasn't gone down a bit. Go lie down and I'll cook dinner.
I'm sorry.
What's this?
A compass. It uses a magnet to tell you which way you're facing.
Woohoo! You can use the sun and stars for that.
And what'll you do if it's cloudy, huh? Thanks to this invention, we'll even be able to voyage across the ocean. See? It's designed to stay level, so your heading will be true even when the ship is rolling with the waves. Pretty neat, right?
If you say so, Laffy.
Come on, it's a must-have for any adventure. Can't you see how useful it is?
You can tell me more about it later.
Did they hurt you?
Not a scratch, and I brought back plenty. I can hear Arthur already.
Gosh, Velvet, I think it's time you learned all my secret arts.
He isn't coming home tonight, is he?
How do you know that?
Sarah stopped by and told me.
Arthur's Moloch? Huh, you really can talk to Molochim, can't you?
Yeah, Arthur says I've got exorcist potential.
No kidding. I think you'll be an exorcist to rival even him. I can tell you've been learning all sorts of things from his book collection.
I really want to become an exorcist. I want to go traveling with you and see all the wonders of the world. I'll hunt and chop firewood, and if demons come for us, I'll defend you. I wish I could do that.
You'll get there, Lafayette. It should only take... 20 years tops.
It won't take me that long.
Oh yeah? You better prove it to me then. Start with this lovely meatball stew I cooked. Eat every last mouthful, even if you don't feel hungry. And take your medicine, no matter how nasty it tastes. No tricks. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, cooking time. First, I need to light the stove.
Come on. There you go. Observation on the Nameless Imperium.
Isn't this Arthur's book? Is Laffy really reading stuff this dense? Poor kid's gonna squint his eyes right out.
The day before Scarlet Night, Sis went prickle boar hunting on her own. She's almost as good a fighter as Arthur, so I know those prickle boars don't stand a chance. But I worry that she's too athletic to land a husband. Maybe she should try to be more ladylike.
Little scamp. He just knew I'd be reading this, didn't he?
Like everyone's picking on her.
It's so easy to light Arthur's firewood. I wonder what his trick is.
Velvet? Could you not put any spinach in the stew?
Huh. You'll never grow up if you're picky with your food, you know.
I know. But just for today?
Fine. I'll leave out the spinach just this once. And I'll make it that curry flavor you like.
Really? Thanks, Velvet!
There's some of Arthur's special curry spice upstairs, isn't there?
There you go.
Not spicy hot, but oh so delicious. Oh yeah, I saw Nico today, and she had very important things to talk about. She's coming over in the next couple days, so be on your best behavior.
I will. I'm glad you've got a good friend.
Yeah, we've known each other since forever. Still, Nico falling in love? I can barely wrap my head around it. Laffy, you know, if there's a girl you like, you'll tell Big Sister all about it, right?
A girl?
You're a stubborn little brat, so you might need an older girl to keep you under control. Oh, and she's gotta be a good cook. A pro in the kitchen is a success at life.
Knock it off, Velvet! You should be more worried about your own love life.
Me? I've got enough on my mind. For one thing, I've got to cook for you and Arthur since Celica is gone. Besides, getting crushes on strange men? I just don't see what's so... Luffy, what's wrong?
She jumps down.
Are you all right? I'll bring you some water.
I'm fine. You just said something funny is all, and it made me choke a bit.
As long as you're okay. Sorry, I went off on a tangent there.
Who knows what the future holds?
Yeah, but what more can I do? I've got a duty to look after my little brother, and I'm serious about it.
I know, but I'm trying to look after you too. I want you to be happy, that's all. And it's not just me. Arthur worries about you too.
Well, we're family, right?
Yeah, that's what families do.
Thanks, Luffy. For you, I'd kill every last prickle boar in the forest if it came down to it. What am I doing? I need to hurry and get dinner ready.
It's over here.
Good boy, you didn't forget your medicine.
Well, I did promise. Tomorrow's a scarlet night.
Yeah, just like that night that changed our lives.
Velvet, may I sleep next to you tonight?
Of course.
That sounded like healing music.
Okay, let's see. Today, I've got to dry some meat and use that cheese I've been saving to make a quiche for... Luffy? You little... Where have you gone? You better not have gone to the village alone! I bet your fever hasn't even gone down!
Yeah, to go check the village. So off we go.
Hey! Has Lafayette been here?
No. I haven't seen him.
Wait! That's one of Arthur's!
Actually, it's a copy that Lafayette made. A smart merchant would pay a pretty penny for this book. I gave him a fair trade.
Luffy, did he really copy all that by hand? He must have done it to buy that compass.
No, though he gave it some puppy eyes. Told him I'd throw it in for free, but he said that it would be a bad deal for me. He's a good lad, but not the merchant type.
So, what did he use the money for?
I'm afraid my lips are sealed. You'll have to ask him.
Velvet, I saw Lafayette walking around. Is he okay?
He's not okay. Where'd you see him? He was headed for the forest. I'll help you look for him.
Thanks. Do a sweep of the village, just in case. I'll check the forest.
Well, let's talk to everyone.
I know. He might have gone to the cape to pick flowers. Have you seen Lafayette?
Nope. Can't say that I have.
All right. Let me know the second you see him.
Got it. Is he in bad shape?
Well, he refuses to stay in bed. He needs his rest, but he's always walking around or reading outside.
I can't say I'm surprised. He's always been a curious lad. He likes reading difficult books. When I saw him the other day, he told me all about the latest navigation techniques and exotic farming methods, too. Only one kid in a million is as smart as he is.
You're exaggerating. Well, maybe not.
It's a shame. If he could go to school in the capital, I'm sure he'd make a name for himself as a scholar.
The capital? Isn't that days and days by ship from Taliesin? No way! Not happening. Even if he gets better, I could never let him go that far away all by himself.
He can handle it. He's actually a very responsible boy. I don't think you need to worry.
I couldn't handle it. I would worry. And be lonely.
Let's go ahead and make a little save here. Yeah, just in case anything happened. I didn't do something stupid now, did I? No, I did not.
Join the search, but they won't move at all. It's like they're scared of something.
Hey, Velvet, did you hear the news? Tonight is going to be another Scarlet Night.
I remember the moon turned red 7 years ago. But what is it anyway?
It's a red lunar eclipse. It happens every several years or so. Apparently, you can predict the next one by watching the movements of the stars. According to legend, a crimson moon is a gate that connects our world to the next. It's also said to be proof of humanity's sins.
You sure know a lot about it.
Lafayette taught me, just a few minutes ago.
You saw Lafayette? Where'd he go?
Actually, I don't know. Sorry.
Alright, let's run to the forest. Yep, gotta run all the way through the forest again.
Alright,
let's fight.
Is that all?
Fluffy!
Velvet.
Can you walk? How's your fever?
I'm fine. I was just taking a break.
Oh, you little... You know better than this, Lafayette. Running off without telling me. What if something happened to you? You wouldn't be the only one hurt. Do you understand that?
I'm sorry.
If you want to do something, just ask. I know I'm a crummy big sister, and I can't afford to buy you all the things you want.
No, that's not why I went out. You see, it was just...
I get it. You're right. I forgot the flowers for the graves.
Yeah, so I was going out to the cape, and I thought...
You want to see the ocean too, don't you?
Well, yeah, that too.
Fine. Just for today, though.
Are you sure?
I am. But next time you run off like that, I'm strapping you to your bed.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. It's off to the Cape, then.
Hooray!
She caved in.
Remember how we went out together to pick Princessias on the morning of Celica's funeral?
Yeah. I was only 4, but I remember. We couldn't find any in the village or at the Cape.
Right. Because the demons had made a mess of them. And then you suddenly started climbing down the edge of the cliff.
You ran over and grabbed me. You had the scariest look on your face.
Of course I did. Do you have any idea what I'd do if I lost you too?
You'd still have Arthur. He'd help you. He'll help the world. He's quite the guy.
That's probably true. But I'd still miss you like you wouldn't believe.
I know. I'm sorry, sis.
But down the cliff from where you were, a lone pair of Princessia were blooming.
I remember. A gentle breeze came in, and it smelled like Celica.
That's right. That's why I believe those flowers were a message from her. Do you know what Princessia flowers signify?
An irreplaceable treasure, and wishes for good health for many years to come.
Right. And that sums up my feelings nicely, Lofi.
Yeah. Me too, sis.
Right, here goes! Megasonic Crash! Hey, Seiya! Seiya! Hey, Seiya! Seiya! Hey! Hey, Seiya!
Bop, 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 bop! There we go.
Is that all? How about I make you some apple boo when we get home, Luffy?
Apple boo? What's that?
Grated apples. Whenever I caught a cold when I was little, Celica would make it for me. It's sweet and tart and juicy and crisp. Eating it always made me feel better.
Well, apples are good for you. But what does the boo mean?
When I was a baby, I would always say boo-boo when I wanted to eat an apple.
So that's where the name comes from. Wait, you called apples boo-boo? You must have been a strange baby.
You used to do the same thing. When Celica and I heard you, we laughed so hard.
Boo!
Right, here goes! Hey, Seiya, help! Hey, Seiya, help! Seiya! Hey, Seiya, help!
God damn it, turn around!
Hey, Seiya, help!
Is that all?
The combat here definitely feels so much better than, Dawn of a New World. Other than, I apparently can't stay on target. Alright, let's make another save here. So memory serves, we're about to get into some heavy stuff here.
Just look at all these! This place never changes, does it?
It does too change. The seasons, the wind, the weather. Change one and the sea's totally different. And the same goes for what lies across the sea.
Across the sea? Sometimes I just don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, Velvet. Thank you for taking me out here today.
You don't need to thank me. Hey, Luffy, do you know why it is that birds fly?
Well, if they didn't, they couldn't catch food or escape from predators.
Thought so.
But you know, I think there's more to it than that. A bird that's born with wings has to...
A demon! Lafayette, run! No matter how much it hurts, run! Velvet! Don't be scared. You can do it. You're going to be strong, like Arthur.
No, you can't!
Go! Why is a demon here?
No, I don't want to go alone!
You have to! Don't let your feelings get in the way, or that thing will kill you too!
But please, go!
It's just like Arthur said. I have to do this! Stop! Face me, demon! How did I get home?
Velvet!
Luffy, you're all right.
Sorry, it's all my fault.
No, if you weren't there, there's no telling what might have happened to me.
Your old one broke, right? You've got beautiful hair. It would be a waste if you didn't take care of it. I'll make a new world. A world where my sister can be happy.
Scarlet Knight? What's going on? Was it all a dream? No, it wasn't!
That comb plays a subtle importance, doesn't it? Yeah. From these guys. We can't damage them yet.
What on earth is going on? This is no time to be scared. I have to find Luffy.
Shit, they about killed everyone.
The village.
Pretty much everyone's dead. What's a friend at? No.
Can't go this way.
No, I don't see her friend. What's her friend's name? Oh shit. That's doggy dead. That's a woman and her baby.
Don't give up. Never give up. Why is a demon here?
Run away, run away, run away, run away, run away.
I've gotta run.
Yes, we can't fight them yet. Stay over there. Leave us alone. Stay away. Ah, that's the safe point. Gotta make it save, save.
Seal to the underworld broken, and tonight here shall be born the power to save the world. With Lothis's life as a sacrifice.
What are you saying?
Go. This is an offering to the world.
Why would you?
Nothing can save him now.
No, no, no!
I see you will not change. Ever a slave to emotion.
That's right, he cut off her arm.
feeds on demons.
Arthur.
A Therian.
Arthur!
Take a look around. Demon blight has spread through the village. But do not fear. With my power as an exorcist, I, Artorius Colbrand, will end your pain. Why is it that birds fly? Behold my answer. Velvet.
Arthur.
I ask no forgiveness. The sin is mine to bear.
I will make you pay!
Yeah, no wonder her view on things got twisted. Ooh, plus 30.
So did my world come to an end. And for 3 long years, I sat in that pit of darkness and fed. Devouring demons. So I could live. So I could live long enough to kill him. And be my brother's vengeance. Where is he? First, there will be a test. It will decide if you are worth teaching.
You are not. I will kill you. Red. Be yourself.
Here I go.
Come on. Why isn't her costume changing as the story progresses?
Why are you holding back?
You noticed. Well done. You pass.
Of course. His Moloch would never be so weak as that.
I am his Moloch no longer. First, let me tell you what has transpired these past 3 years. There are exorcists now throughout the land, challenging the reign of demons with the help of...
Tell me. Tell me where Artorias is.
You may find him in the capital city of Logris in Midgand. You won't stop to listen. I can tell you what it was you saw that night. That night, the ritual he performed shifted the very course of the world. A host of Malakim descended, and with their strength, the emergent exorcists quelled the demon tide. Now, he serves as leader of the Exorcist's Abbey, an institution that enjoys the unconditional faith of the kingdom and public. A shield to guard the people and a sword against demons, Artorias Colbrand, the world's savior.
With power stolen by sacrificing Lafiset.
Indeed, but his power is not yet absolute. The man can still be killed.
Why are you doing this?
Make a successful escape from this place, and I'll explain.
Escape? So that's your game. Fine. I don't care what the world thinks of me. What matters is my vengeance against Artorias. That's all.
I have shattered your yoke. We must hurry.
Shit. Well, that's what she's supposed to look like. But... Got a silver coin.
There are weapons in the room ahead.
It's still can't.
No one raised the alarm.
I can see that.
Take what you need from here.
Still can't.
It looks like they kept prisoners' effects in here.
Rope. This will be useful. Quite a blade.
I know that sword. Stormhowl! What is it doing here?
Well, it's too big for me.
You're not taking it? It's a celebrated masterpiece.
And if I can't use it, it's worthless.
Yeah, our costume's supposed to change.
All right.
Are you ready then?
What's going on here?
Be careful. He's no ordinary soldier. He's an exor...
You didn't even flinch.
I already told you. I am his Moloch no longer.
Is there a ship waiting?
So you already know we're on an island?
Yes. I've learned that this is a prison island for violent criminals, and that there are scores of demons locked away here. Demons say lots of things when they don't want you to eat them.
The prison has docks at both the front and rear entrances. Our ship is on the back side.
Got it. The back docks.
Okay, now we can change equipment. That's a normal hairstyle. That was her prison outfit. Now she's... Right? Yeah. No normal outfit. It's a bit curious. What is this? Let's check that out right quick. Now that looks like velvet. Alright, let's make a save here.
What is this thing?
That's a special mass of mana. Think of them as the souls belonging to a family of Malakim. They appeared all over after the Advent 3 years ago.
Another after effect of the Advent.
If you collect enough of them, you might be able to solicit the cooperation of a Moloch family.
And I'm supposed to take your word for it?
I'm not forcing you to do anything. Whether you collect them or not is up to you.
I might as well pick them up. I'll use every tool at my disposal.
Indeed. You'll have to if you want your revenge.
Okay, I take it that's the way that was supposed to go. Okay, yeah, that way... Let's say we... Can I say we come back here in the future? Later on in the game? I do not remember. Oh damn, I got a shit ton of those already.
Guards coming. Two of them. This way.
Did you hear? The path around the island is off limits now. They say the ground's weak and could collapse.
The path that goes under the watchtower? That's all right. Nobody uses it anyway.
True, but it was a nice shortcut to the docks.
A shortcut to the docks? Under the watchtower.
A number of guards have gone missing. It would seem we have intruders on the island. All exorcists, break into two groups and converge at the front and rear gates.
Understood. No one will get past us.
Stay sharp. The threat could be serious.
Yes, sir.
This isn't going to be easy.
Then we'll need reinforcements of our own. Where are the cells?
They should be on this floor. You plan on involving the other prisoners?
I'll use any tool I have at my disposal.
She's gonna start a prison riot. Go.
Who in the blazes are you?
We're finished here. Let's go.
Serious?
Split into two groups and rush the front and rear gates. Break through the gates and you'll have a ship.
But aren't they guarded by exorcists? I mean, that pirate Von Eifried's the only one who's ever broken out of here.
And he didn't pull it off just by himself. He was hauled out by some old exorcist named Melchior or something.
Von Eifried and Melchior.
I won't force you. You want to rot in here, then rot.
I'm with you. Anything's better than another day in this rat
hole. Let's do it. I'm going home to my family.
Me too.
Yeah.
Let me out,
Rogues
girl.
Rogues like us are always
I'm
up for a gamble.
I'm sick of the slop they feed us.
Ceres. That ought to draw the attention of the guards. In the meantime, we'll search for that watchtower. From there, we can follow the outer path down to the docks.
So you're leaving them all to their fates?
I told you. We'll use any tool I need.
All right, let's check these places out, see if there's anything. Copper coin. there, to there, to around there. Nothing in here.
You're not going to escape?
Don't underestimate the exorcists. They're all gonna die like dogs. Or goblins.
This abbey that's in charge of this place. They're that amazing.
Amazing doesn't even begin to cover it. The exorcists of the abbey joined forces with the kingdom of Midgan. And they've got the whole world in their pocket. They're merciless. They hunt down any human who becomes a demon. Going against them means taking on the whole world.
And I bet I know who's at the top.
Those who get captured and sent here are the lucky ones. We may be monsters, but at least we have our lives.
Sure. Until they get fed to me. Thanks for the info.
Even if you manage to escape this place, thousands of exorcists controlling powerful Malakim will be out there waiting for you. There's nowhere for you to run. Nowhere.
I'm not going to run. I'll gladly die, as long as I take Artorias with me.
By the way, that reminds me. Let's change this back to normal. Let's see what the difference is, music-wise. Another one of those. What are these used for? I forget. Let's see, anything useful in here? Nope, nope. Nope. You guys just kind of hanging around. Ooh, something in there. Chest here. Out of boots. But that reminds me, did we get any new equipment? Blood blade. Nothing. Nothing. Ooh, yeah, might as well. Oh, random skill. Gonna do that. This title? I think this might be the title. Yeah, this would be titles. Furious Fighter. Start the Crusade. So that's the same. Demonic Duelist. That goes down. Let's stats go up. Take some difficulty. Add a maniac. Combat swaps. Didn't want like that one. Fade attacks. That yet. Kicks and chain with sword arms to bloody battlefield. I guess this is the best title. See what's over here. Anything? Anything? Oh, it's on your bed. Do not remember what those are used for. Nothing, nothing. Alright.
Not a word of apology? What is wrong with you people? There I was, sleeping like a sweet babe, when suddenly... From paradise down to hell!
No worse, a grimy prison cell!
You see why I'm not feeling well.
And you are?
Hooray! You asked! I'm thrilled to introduce to you the wise sorceress who travels the 11 seas, who scoffs at the might of dragons! None other than the acclaimed, the illustrious, Magilou-Dindo-Dindo-Larundu! Magilou for short.
Magilou?
No, Ma! Like Soggy Shoe or Doggy Doo! Or call me any of those things and I'll turn you into a froggy stew! I suppose you'll never understand. People can be so tragically unlearned. But hey, like I care!
Okay, Magilou? I know she's a character.
I can't believe she snuck up on me. Who is she?
This is no ordinary prison. We must be cautious. Trust no one. She said she's a powerful witch.
Did she have a Moloch tethered?
No, I didn't sense Malakim around her. She's an ordinary human, I think.
Then she's an ordinary magician, not a witch. If she tries to trick me again, I'll crush her and be done with it.
It begs the question. Why was she dressed like that? Is that like a hot spring town? I think we go this way. No, go this way. Unlock those costumes. I want to say, on my playthrough, I didn't play as Magilou. Use her very often. Shit, I don't know. 3 years ago. Knows what I was thinking then.
More?
This one. He's a demon!
Get ready.
You're not human.
Neither are you.
True enough.
That crashed through!
Hold up! See this? Destruction!
There we go.
Hold up! Hold up! See this?
Speed dragon!
He's strong.
Chips in the blades already. Brittle these exorcist knives. I've got to reclaim Storm Howl.
Storm Howl? That sword we found?
You found it? Where? Do you have it? Please tell me.
It's in a storage room. Down below.
Down below? You have my thanks.
He's an odd demon.
If things settle down, we'll miss our window. Hurry!
Stormhell? Could that demon be...
What is it?
Nothing. That demon swordsman was just strange. He was so full of fury, but when you started talking about that sword, his manner changed completely.
Don't think too much about it. He's a demon, after all.
The prisoners here are all so unusual. Except for you.
Forget it. Like I care what a Moloch thinks of me.
And by that.
Here I go!
What, you wanna fight?
We're finished here. Let's hurry on.
Getting out of here comes first.
The tower should be just ahead.
I think we need to go this way. Yep.
We've just about quelled this riot. You won't be getting away.
Come on, really?
The prisoners are doomed.
Time is short. We need to get down to the path.
That up. Up we go. It's just some gold.
The path has collapsed. That rope won't do any good here. Wait, you're not seriously going to try it, are you?
He fell further than this back at the shrine.
I see you are truly committed to this. You're strong. I would almost think you made an oath. It's a ritual that grants special power if the oath taker abides by certain restrictions. The harsher the restrictions, the greater the power one may command. In a very real sense, an oath is a sort of curse, right?
Well, guess what? You're the ones who did this to me.
I am aware. That is why I chose you.
She's a bit crazy. Why would you jump off that? And it ended up just slipping on his shoulder and slammed into a wall to pop back in. Alright, let's make it safe here. Oh, what time is it? I think we'll go a little bit longer because I think we're almost off the island. Once we get off the island, we'll call it good. Unless there's a lot more to go.
Are you sure? This way leads to the main entrance.
If they know you're here, they'll have found your ship by now. The guards expect us at the rear, not the front. We're almost there.
That's enough.
Oscar, I had no idea an exorcist praetor had been assigned to this island.
You surprise me, Ceres. Aiding criminals now, are you? Did Lord Artorius request this?
No, I'm acting on my own.
A Moloch with free will? And yet, I sense someone's strings guiding me.
Hold on. A praetor is far more dangerous than an orderly.
I'm all out of subterfuge. And besides, if we can't overpower this one, our end goal was hopeless to begin with.
You're a demon, but still a lady, so I'll show you due respect. I am Oscar Dragonia, praetor of the Abbey of the Holy Midgand Empire. Who might you be?
Huh.
All right. Graceless demon it is, then. Lord Artorius himself taught me the ways of purification. How will you fare against them?
Okay, now we can focus on him.
You're skilled. I will have to expend a Moloch or two for this.
More of your vaunted reason.
No!
A Moloch with demon blight?
It's lost control.
Wounds are fatal. Please, consume me.
I'm not about to.
My form is bound by an oath whose price is my life. The time has come to pay. Feeding on my form will grant you strength, the strength to press forward. I ask only that you devour me.
Why?
A flame burns in my heart, too. A flame I cannot quench, no matter how hard I try. Just like you, Velvet.
This was Laffy's.
That is why I cannot abide it. This frozen world, this frozen people, I'm just that stubborn of a woman. Hurry, before my life fades. Do it now.
I offer no apology or thanks.
I need neither. Our wishes... are one and the same. I treasured those days. When you and I and Arthur were together.
If you don't, I'll eat you!
He absorbed that Moloch's power to wield the throne? I've never seen such a demon! But I can't let a nasty demon like you roam freely now, can I?
Velvet. That's my name. You can give Artorias my regards. My name is Velvet Crow, and I will devour demon. Moloch. And exorcist alike! I am a monster! I am a Therian!
Tower. I thought, this is it, Magilou. This is the end!
It would have been less risky if you hadn't suddenly appeared and jumped on my back. Oh, hey, it's you. It's thanks to you that Stormhowl is back in my care. Rokurou gets it. At your service. This blade is my life. I owe you a great debt. One I vow to repay.
Yes, yes, she's a peach and a model citizen. Can we get our move on? I think they're just about done massacring the rioters!
The docks are just ahead. Give me a hand.
The weather's feeling as crummy as I am.
Careful. Sea's looking mighty choppy.
Are you a sailor?
No, but I do know the difference between a sail and a rudder.
I'll take what I can get. Do what you can.
You're leaving without a proper crew?
Very well, then. I certainly owe you this much, at least.
Brave words. But 10 minutes in this storm, and you'll lose all sense of direction.
No, we won't. Ships have compasses for a reason.
So it's rot in a jail cell, or rot in a fish tummy? Well, guess it's your lucky day, fishies!
I'm coming for you, Artorias. Luffy said... a Moloch?
Ah!
Stay back!
That all you got?
Oh, come on! There we go.
My word! A demon muncher! You really are a box of horrors, aren't ya?
Sorry. If I had a weapon, I would have helped. I promise.
You're wearing one.
Oh, nah, I can't use this. Sorry, long story.
And the child?
The little brat? Scampered off somewhere.
You ought to be scampering off yourselves.
My debt is not yet repaid. Until it is, I will not leave your side.
I can hardly scamper off without knowing from whence I'm scampering! We're lost, stranded, shipwreck survivors, no?
Well, then I expect this might come in handy.
A map? Was that left by the child?
Looks to me like we're in Northgand.
Northgand? Then if we're to reach the capital in Midgand, we've no choice but to patch up our ship.
What are your plans once you reach Logris? Something worth breaking out of prison for.
Oh, can't we stand around and chat somewhere nicer? Somewhere with soup to warm the body, tales to warm the heart?
There's a city called Helavis nearby. I can't promise there much for conversation, but we'll find food and a ship right there.
All right, let's check this.
Velvet, you know that kid? I thought I heard you call him by name.
No, I don't know any Malakim. Not anymore.
Anymore?
What?
Well, whoever he was, there was something different about him, that's for sure.
You can say that again. Using healing arts on a demon without being ordered to?
And he stole that compass, too. For being an exorcist Moloch, he's a greedy little imp.
Well, we did help ourselves to a certain map of his, so...
I consider myself an island of virtue in this sea of wickedness.
I suppose.
Come on, it's not funny if you agree with me.
You think?
So this is how escaped prisoners behave.
mind is still stuck with Velvet. Let's make it safe. I do want to change the costume.
Magilou, your way of speaking is as strange as your appearance.
Hey, I'm a witch. I must project a proper age and dignity. I have an image to maintain.
Self-improvement in all things, I suppose. So what's the difference between a spellcaster and a witch?
There are many, but mainly it's a matter of nuance. It's like the difference between being frugal and being miserly.
Ah, so a spellcaster is useful and a witch isn't, is that it? So I guess that makes you a witch right now.
You wound me. You're one to talk, Mr. Self-Improvement. Your words cut deeper than these northern winds. Oh, the wind, it bites! How can you stand wearing that garb? It doesn't seem humanly possible.
I never said I was human.
Avoid these things right now.
So nice to be free again. Able to move these bones around like I want.
So, Rokurou, what got you all chained up in that mold hole?
Ties to home. It's complicated.
Oh! Then are you really sure you ought to be taking on further debts?
It's a teaching of House Rangetsu. Pay what you owe.
Well, what a civilized family you've got.
Were you in for long?
3 years, maybe. That's why I know so little about the state of the world.
Oh gosh, me too! Art-wielding Malakim! I've never seen such a thing! How much else have I missed? Used to be witches who had a monopoly on charms and hexes. Can you even comprehend what this'll do to business?
Should I even ask why you were imprisoned?
Ha! Bagged for unlicensed witchcraft. It was a tale of betrayal most wicked and foul! Care to hear more? You'll cry, I'll laugh, emotions will touch the rafters!
No, thank you.
We just run a little bit farther here. Hey, cats.
Oh no, I'm in so much trouble, so much trouble. Won't somebody please help a kitty out, meow?
Oh look, another weirdo.
That thing talks? What if it's a cat demon?
Simmer down, big man. She's just a cat. Haven't seen one in a good long while.
Cats? Is that different from a regular cat somehow?
It's complicated. Cats are a mysterious bunch. Just think of them as a special kind of Moloch. Sort of.
That works for me. I understand that they're hard to understand, at least.
Hey, I don't suppose you happen to be carrying any cat spirits on you. They look like this.
That's just like what I found at Titania.
Perfect. You could say they're kind of like our souls to us.
Cat spirits, huh?
Sometimes we call them kitten caboodles, too.
That's just foolish.
Really? Then how about kitty clumps? Anyway, one night we were having a feast so meowvelous, our souls flew right out of our bodies. That's why I need your help to find the cat spirits and use them to immeowsipate my friends.
Immeowsipate? Really?
It means to use cat spirits to free cats who are locked away in cats' boxes like these here, meow. Here you'd say apesipate. This one would be edoxipate. And finally...
Phew! I'm free, meow!
See? Emulsipate!
By that logic, shouldn't it be ecatsipate?
Wow, you're way more clever than you look! For real! I guess I totally underestimated you. Please, our cat spirits got scattered far and wide, and so many sad cats are trapped without them.
Seek out the cat spirits and rescue our poor lost brothers and sisters, meow.
And why should I?
Please, think of the cats.
You know, cats have weird and mysterious powers. There's a good chance we might benefit by having them in our debt. We'll make it worth your while, I promise. And If we snub them, they might put a curse on us.
That has been known to happen.
Ew.
If we're doing all this traveling anyway, why not help them on the side?
Just remember that it's on the side.
That's right. I remember now. Okay, yeah. Run back in, make a save, and then we'll call that for the night. Maybe by the time it need to just let them need to call it. So I hope you all enjoyed. I know I'm having fun. And we'll do this for a while, and then we'll go from there and. We'll have some Pokemon here too. So, have a good evening, and I shall see you next time.